So I'm Paul Harris. I'm a developmental psychologist. I worked for many years in Europe and England before moving to the United States in 2001. And currently I teach at Harvard in the School of Education, which allows me to meet lots of students from various parts of the world. And my primary teaching is in the field of human development, especially early human development. And my research is concerned primarily with cognitive development, but I also have interest in emotional development and the development of the imagination. So if we ask ourselves how children acquire religious concepts and scientific concepts and the extent to which they're similar, I would argue that there are indeed important similarities. First of all, many scientific and religious concepts refer to things that we can't observe firsthand. They're hidden from us, they're invisible. Secondly, many scientific and religious concepts identify things that are invisible but also have some causal powers. They bring about effects that we can see. And those things, I think, mean that probably the way in which children have to learn about certain scientific and religious concepts is similar in that they have to rely on what other people tell them. And so that means that children will often have difficulty in testing these ideas for themselves. To some extent, they'll have to believe in, accept, trust what other people tell them. So indeed, a lot of my own work is on the notion of testimony, and I argue that children accept the testimony of other people, both with respect to religious ideas and with respect to scientific ideas. And then that leads me to the question of, well, is the child likely to believe everything that they're told? What sort of reservations do they entertain? Are there particular types of informants or groups that they are especially attentive to? And so there's in fact in a whole research enterprise concerned with how children learn from testimony, which I see as covering both the domains of science and history. And I would also actually add in something else, which obviously is difficult for children to observe if we take history. It's not as if we can take the child by the hand and show them what happened in the past. We typically tell them about the past via narratives. So there's another domain where the child is dependent on other people.